Okay, guys, it's time for a bit more science fun. Today I'm going to talk a bit about the hardware that I'm using to collect my brain data from a company called Muse, using a device called the Muse 2. Let's open it very carefully. Don't break that shit.
Don't drop that.
Very delicate. So here we have the headband, which is placed on the head like this. Full sensor connectivity. Like so. If you have a good look at the inside, you can see, let's see how I do this. This middle sensors, grounding sensors, AF7, AF8, TP9, TP10. What is TP9, TP10, AF7, AF8? These are standardized names for locations of nodes used in experimental neuroscience in a system called the 1020 system, or the 10-20 system. I'm actually not sure, because I've only read about it. I've never heard anybody actually use the word verbally. Anyhow, this ensures that whether the experiment is with a relatively simple device like a Muse2 or a more complex device in a laboratory, if you use the 1020 system with labels like AF7, AF8, TP9 and 10, like in my case, the experiments are more repeatable. Future scientists or technologists know exactly which node that data was coming from, which is important. So when you have a more complex experiment in a more complex laboratory, because this ain't a regular laboratory. This ain't your mama's laboratory. This is jungle science, baby. This shit. You think I'm playing around? This is the fucking jungle. So you need something that scales well from the jungle to any laboratory. So think about it. It works in our favor. Ayahuasca is a relatively significant neural event. So I am hoping that even with a low resolution piece of hardware like this, we should be able to still read in some statistically significant data. If I were testing the effects of eating an apple on the brain, I assume eating an apple is a pretty insignificant neural event. You might need some more complex hardware. And even that more complex hardware may not give any conclusive results, because eating an apple is such a mundane thing. But ayahuasca is significant enough that even on 4 nodes from the Muse 2, we may be able to see some sort of statistically significant change in the brainwaves. Okay, until next time.